Let us see what is the two things required for total internal reflection. One is the light rays should travel from denser medium to rarer medium. Second thing is the angle of incidence in the denser medium should be greater than the critical angle. Okay. So if I have a fiber like this, if light ray is passing through this way, you can't expect the light ray to pass straight like this. Now the fiber is bent. Okay. Now this is the medium. Surrounding this is the fiber. Surrounding this fiber, we have one more part. We'll call it as a, this is the core. So this internal part is called the core, and this you call it as a cladding. Cladding is the cover, core is the internal area. Now the light ray is incident at a particular angle on the cross section of the fiber. What's happening is, once it is crossing into the boundary, it is going from air into the fiber medium. Definitely fiber medium is the optically denser medium compared to the air. So it will bend towards the normal. This is the normal, assuming it will bend towards the normal and go this way. Wherever it is striking here, okay, at this point of incidence, if I draw a normal to the surface, this angle here, angle of incidence between the denser medium and the rarer medium, whatever the cladding you have, that cover, outer cover, okay, that medium is rarer compared to the core medium, optically rarer. So now the light ray is intended to travel from the core to cladding. In such a scenario, here if it is the angle of incidence, it is devised in such a way that this angle of incidence here is greater than the critical angle of light of the core with respect to the cladding. Critical angle of core with respect to the cladding. So then what will happen is, it will not undergo refraction, it will undergo total internal reflection. It will travel this way. This angle of incidence is equal to angle of reflection here. So if it is traveling this direction here, it will travel along the, it will reflect and then travel. This way, whatever the bending it is there, it will travel and go, so that we are able to bend the light. This is the basic principle involved in how does a optic fiber work. Okay. The other application, what you see observed in nature regarding total internal reflection, is mirage. You know, mirages are observed in not only in desert areas, but also on sometimes on the metal roads. Suppose you are going on a highway in a car, at a very far off distance, you will be able to see that there appear to be something like water is there. When you go nearer, you don't find any water over there. What's happening is, it is because of the total internal reflection that it appears as if sky is reflected over there, sky being blue. Okay. Because of the total internal reflection, is appearing that as if there is a sky over there, sky being blue, so it will appear as if there is some water over there. Okay. Air is considered to be of multiple layers, and when you go from land towards a greater heights, altitudes, what's happening is, the density of air is changing. Okay. It is cooler at the higher levels and it is hotter near the surface of the land. So when light is traveling from a distant place, what's happening is, it is not getting refracted. At a stage comes where it will undergo total internal reflection, and then you are seeing the total internal, because of the total internal reflection, you are seeing the sky over there. And that's how, as if water is there, it will appear as if some water is there at a distant place. So this is the concept of a mirage. Okay.